Hi guys, this is Basan. In this video we are going to see how to generate REST documentation API using JSON docs. In my previous video I already uploaded how to generate document using Spring Boot with Swagger example. So now let's see the same way how we can generate the documentation using JSON docs API. So let's do one small POC to understand how it's working and how the flow is going on. So let's start now. Let's create one Maven project, which is Spring Boot application. Okay. Name it as Spring JSON docs. Okay, packages let it be. Now add the required dependency. So I am adding here dev tools, in memory database h2, and web application. To make it web application I added web, and to perform the persistence API I added JPA, and to ignore getter setter, to write manually I added Lombok. What else? Okay fine. Now let's start the development. Okay, now create the required package. Create a package with name model. Then controller, then persistence DAO layer, then create package service, okay, model DAO controller service. What else we need? Fine, let's start. So create a model class. Let's take it employee class. Add some attribute like employee ID, then department, employee name, then department, then salary. Okay, now annotate to make it the model which is going to save our database. So that's why write entity, then specify the table. If you are not specifying any name of table, then by default it will take your class name and it will generate the table with your same class name. Then add ID, we need to make one primary key. Okay, and I want this ID should be auto generated. So add generated value. So I don't want to write setter getter here, that's why add lambda provided annotation setter and getter. And add to string also. Then I am adding the constructor. Okay, we almost added all the annotation. Now write the DAO layer. I am using JPA repository here, because some CRUD operation I want to show here, so that I don't want to write configuration to integrate with Hibernate, and it is more easy to work for simply CRUD operation. So employee repository, this is one interface, and extends it from JPA repository. You can extend from CRUD repository as well. This is type parameter, pass your model class. Our model class is employee. Okay, and serializable ID. This ID should be your primary key data type. Okay, so make it integer. Then write service now. Employee service annotate @service, and we need to inject DAO inside service. So inject the employee repository. Inject using auto add. So now write some 2-3 method to show the documentation for them. I will write here one post and one get method to show you how it generates the documents. So write one post public, and what should be the return type? Make it string only. Save employee. Okay, we need to pass the employee object to save it in our database. Okay, now return some dummy value. New employee. Added with ID. Same ID just set here, which we are going to save. Okay. Now save here. Call the repository dot save method. Save the employee object. Okay, now write one get method, public employee, get employee, then we need to get the employee based on one specific field, so pass the employee ID here. Because ID always will be unique only. So now directly return repository.find one. Okay, so this method will return the employee object based on the employee ID, and write one more method. Let's write one more method for delete. Public, let's return type list of employee. Delete employee. Here also you need to pass one unique field to get the employee or to delete the employee. To delete, call the repository dot delete, give the ID here, and as we mentioned, the return type list of employee. After delete one employee object, the number of employee available that I want to return the list of employee. So call repository dot find all. Okay, so we are done with our four service method. Now try to map the URL in controller for these four method. Employee controller. Okay, annotate@rest controller. Now we need to inject the service inside controller. So inject by autoware. So now we need to write these three method, and we need to map the URL. So first one is our post method. Write public string. I am writing it only save so that we can easily identify. And return, I am returning directly from service what response I am getting there. Okay, so this employee is the request body. So annotate with at request body. Okay, and this method is post. So we can directly annotate like @post mapping, but the issue is here in JSON docs it will not support for these annotation like post mapping, get mapping, this kind of HTTP method type annotation it will not support. So that is one disadvantages of this JSON docs. So for that we need to write only the request mapping annotation, and then there we need to specify the method value equal to something. Save employee. And then here we need to specify the method type. This method type is post. Okay, so same way write for get and delete. For get, here we need to pass one parameter, and then call the service. Okay, and annotate this is the get method. So I'm writing URL get employee. And the method type I need to change here, that should be the get. If I will not specify this method type for each API here, then in JSON docs that HTML page by default it will take all method as get method only. So we can test properly there. Now write the delete. Delete employee, make the method name, and here also we need to pass on unique field, then return call the service directly. Change the URL, delete employee, and here we need to change the method type, that should be delete. Okay, and we are passing one field as a request URL. So let's annotate @ path variable. Okay, and we need to pass the parameter here also. Okay, these are three methods we are expecting, and one more thing, like we need to work with JSON docs, we need to enable the JSON related stuff, some properties or some configuration we need to add. So even we didn't add the dependency, let's add the dependency to work with JSON docs. Let me copy paste. This is org json docs, and this is easy to integrate with Spring Boot, so that Spring Boot starter json docs is available. Okay, now we need to enable the json docs to generate the html. So write @ enable json docs. Okay, so here we need to inform JSON docs to scan, this is my controller, this is my model, and this is the flow. So we need to specify, and the version which we are using, these things we need to inform to JSON docs, then only JSON docs will be able to generate the HTML documentation for us. So we can follow the multiple approach, we can write the YML file, or we can use the Java-based config. So here I am using the properties file. So here these are the JSON docs provided, key and value. Like you need to specify the version 1.0 and JSON docs .base path or packages. So let's specify the base path. So I have already, let's copy these three. These are the required where you need to specify the package, like this is the array. We can specify the controller and the model. Okay, JSON docs API. So I want to generate the HTML documentation for these two packages, controller and model. If you want for other package also, you can specify the index 2, 3, like packages index in properties file, so that we can configure. So as of now I am configuring only my controller and model. So I think I configure all. So let's start our application and we'll check whether it is generating the documentation or not. Okay, some JSON docs related request URL mapped here, and it's run on port 8080. Let's test. Localhost 8080 slash JSON docs UI. This is the URL you need to hit. Then again, we need to give the up to this JSON docs in search bar. Okay. Okay, it's generated the document. So here object is nothing, our model class. This is the model class. And with all the fields, if you want, you can add the description for each field. We'll do in later. That for that we need to add some annotation. And this is the API with four method: post, get, delete. So this is the post method. Okay, here is the request body. ID is auto generated, so let it remove name. Suppose add name Peter. Department IT and salaries, let's 5000. Okay, now submit. To work with this, actually you need to connect with the internet. There is some issue in my internet, so else you will get your response text that what we are returning from our controller. Okay, so let me check the internet. No, it's fine. So this is the way we can test from directly here instead of using Postman or SOAP UI. Like same way Sagar also gave us the template to test our application. And this is the produces, this is the consumes, the media type, and the status code. It is default. If you want, you can change using the annotation. So we'll do some annotation and we'll check. So same way for delete and get method, you can test. Okay, so for delete also same. Actually it's showing for delete and get we are passing one path variable, this one field, which is mandatory, and that we need to annotate with API path param, something is there that we will check now. Let's check some annotation. Okay, first let's change our API description and all. So write @API. Okay, here we can write the name, description and all. Suppose I am writing API name employee management system. Okay, and add the description. Description I am adding like employee info. Then add the group, which group this one belongs to. assume something, write management. Then visibility, whether you want it to public or private, so you can do that. I am making it public. Okay, and if you want to enable in stage, so you can enable using this attribute and with the stage version. Okay, this is the API, this employee controller API means the header section, API service section. And if you want to pass relate, if you want to change some description or method type in your method label, then we can annotate @API method. Okay, API method, some description, something. Okay, description. Write save employee, else add new employee. Then as here we are passing the employee object, here we need to pass the API path form. As it is object, so let it be. So same for this get employee and delete employee. So write API method description. I am writing find employee by ID. Okay, and what else? Path is our ID which we are passing. So give that name, and we need to annotate @API path param at method argument. Okay, description, input ID, write it employee ID so that we can check input employee ID. And what else? Name equal to ID. Okay, so the proper place of this annotation is, as I told, it's on method argument. Okay, so same copy paste here, we'll change the name and description. Here also it's input employee ID. To make more clear, write this to get to delete. Okay, and we need to write API method annotation also here. And this is delete or remove. Okay, and now let's change some annotation, or let's make more proper in our model class, so that we means anyone can easily know that the role of each attribute in model. So for that, I think @API object. If you don't want to visible this, you can specify show false, but I want to show as part of my HTML. That's why I'm by default it will take true, so I want to make it enable for all. So now API object field, name equal to employee ID. And add some description. Auto generated ID. Okay, same way for other also we can add. Something like employee name. Here give some description like name, same match, like any ID proof, voter ID. Okay, give some description to see the document format. So we can change it later based on our requirement. This is the department. Change the description. Department section. Same for salary also. Let's copy paste. Write it salary. Annual, annual income. So this is the way we can add the name and description that it will reflect on our JSON docs HTML page. I think it should be auto restarted. I added dev tools. Okay. Okay, now let's test. Okay, this is the group which we added in API annotation at class level, and this is the name we added. Okay, if you will check the model class here also, the object field recently which we added, it will reflect. Why it's not showing? Let's check here. Okay, here it's reflecting. For get employee we write get employee ID. And visibility is, this is the URL, path URL, and the visibility you add public, and in stage it should be the beta version, and producers consume description we added find employee by ID, it's on method level, and this is the path parameter. Okay, this is required true, and description we added there at the rate input path param. Input employee to get ID. Okay, same for delete also. I think it will reflect. Yes, it's reflecting. Input employee ID for delete and visibility, it stays. All those description and name which we annotated, it reflect here properly. Okay, and let's check object. It should be display here. Maybe I don't know, there is some internet issue for that, it's not recognized or what. Cause it's reflecting here which we added. So it should be reflect there also, it's not an issue. This is the way we can annotation, and some more annotation is there. Let's check, suppose you don't want to show the default error. You can annotate at the rate API errors, okay, in class level, and some global information also you can provide, and for that we need to specify some HTML file in your resource path. And in API migration details also you can annotate. Then there, if you mark, there is one flow section is there. Here we didn't add anything, that's why it's showing empty. So if you want, you can add the API, these three annotation: API flow set, API flow, API flow state. These three annotation we can add to like enable this field, this section, and it will show you the flow like the sequence diagram. So these are the annotation we can use to more it make clear, to make it more clear. And if you want, you can add the header section, API header. It can be applicable in method level and class level. And API version also you can mention. Okay, these are the annotation we can use in our this application to enable to generate the JSON docs. So okay, we didn't save it, maybe for that reason it's not showing. Let's see. It's reflecting now. That time actually I didn't save. So what are the fields we added? Auto generated ID, this description we added. And a name same as voter ID, and like these are the name, this is the name, and this is the description which we added. And type required, here required is false. If you want, you can make it mandatory. So this is the way we can generate the documentation using JSON docs. That's it for particular video. If you like this video, please go ahead and subscribe it, and thanks for watching this video.